What is going on to all you beautiful people on YouTube? Welcome back to my channel, or if you just clicked on this video, welcome to this channel. Anyway, today we have a comment request by this guy right here. He says, "Hello, comrade," and then he sends the link. This is a guy from the channel that I really do like because he comments on everything, and I really do appreciate you, man. I really do. You are an amazing person, and yeah, I like that you comment the videos. But anyway, today he requested Rammstein auch dich Stalingrad. So, yeah, this is Rammstein, the band. I heard one song about it in How High the Movie. They have this, Du hast nicht. Yeah, so, yeah. Anyway, let's just get into this video and see what it's all about. I have no idea, but I think it's a song about war, of course. But, yeah, I can see this guy right here looking like he's just in pain and he's just shell-shocked. Shell-shocked is something they used in World War I to describe PTSD. War or something. So, yeah. Anyway, let's just get into this video and see what it's all about. Let's go. Oh, am I gonna cry? I really don't hope so. Oh, shit. What the hell happened? Wow. Just looking at his friends dead.
Ich werde in die Tannen gehen, dahin, wo ich sie zuletzt gesehen. Doch der Abend wirft ein Tuch aufs Land und auf die Wege hinterm Waldesrand. Und der Wald, er steht so schwarz und leer, weh mir, oh weh.
Wow.
Und die Vögel singen nicht mehr. Ohne dich kann ich nicht sein. Ohne dich.
Oh, das ist brutal. I'm getting goosebumps. This is horrible, man.
Auf den Ästen in den Gräben ist es nun still und ohne Leben. Und das Atmen fällt mir ach so schwer. Die Vögel singen nicht mehr. Ohne dich kann ich nicht sein. Ohne dich. Mit dir bin ich auch allein. Ohne dich.
Wow.
Ohne dich zähl ich die Stunden. Ohne dich. Mit dir.
I must be horrible, man. Man, this makes me depressed, man.
Ohne
Wow. That is horrible, man. Now, I know it's a movie, and I know it's not real, but it's real. You know what I mean? Like, it's a certain history that we have in the world that is not... It's not beautiful and it's not good, but thankfully we have another world. But we do have a problem with the Middle East, and they are the next, of course. This is just horrible. Like, I could imagine, like, every single time I watch a scene with some soldier, I imagine it real life. Like, real life soldiers actually having to hatch up their brothers, actually have to burn their brothers they've been in war with, actually have to burn their people because they fight some stupid war that some politic is gonna say, do this, do that, and then people just gonna die. It's fucking stupid and it's retarded, but it is what it is. It's the world and it's history and it has become. Now, I know that Germany people, they were very mean towards other people, but you have to understand that not every German that fought the war, World War II, is a bad guy. Because you have to understand that they have no choice. What is the choice? The choice is either you die, or your family dies, or you fight. Yeah, and that's it. And not everybody is ready to die, because it's so easy to say in the comment down below that it's so easy, you could just say no. You cannot say no if you're scared of death, if you're scared of dying. You cannot say no. But I know it's a bad history, and I see that. I can't imagine, like, standing on a fucking road and you're about to get shot by a fucking Germany kid that's 17, 18, or whatever he is. Like, that's just... It pisses me off because this is the history that we have to live with, and I know that we have to live with it, but nobody needs to blame anybody for anything that happened because it's over. It's 2019, almost 2020. And it's just, I don't get that people, they still, you know, think about the war and think about history back in the days and all these things, because we need to move forward. But rest in peace to all these soldiers that die. I really do mean it from the bottom of my heart. You fought for something great, you fought for something good. And all the Russian people that died, even though that you did rape kids and you did rape children and women and all this, there were still soldiers that helped the world come to this place that we are now. Because without World War II, we wouldn't have the world that we live in right now. Because all of the rules, all of the human rights, all of this stuff. So I just want to say thank you, Russia, and thank you, America, and thank you every single country that fought and, you know, got the pain of it. And my country too, Denmark, even though we did give up, or Copenhagen gave us up, we still fighting, that's why. There's a movie about it, I think it's called 2nd of April or something like that, where Danish soldiers, they walk in the city right next to mine, and they're still fighting against the Germans, and the Germans are saying to them, why are you still fighting? Your government already gave up. And you know, it cracks my spirit every time I look at it, because I'm like, my government is a fucking pussy. We need to fight until the last man, and we need to fight until all our people are dead. Like, I don't, like, it's just the country's love, you know what I mean? Like, that's what I want to do if somebody attacks us. I want to fight for my country. But yeah. Anyway, guys, this is very depressing, and it makes me a little bit pissed, but it is what it is in this story, and we have to live with it. But I just want to say that all respect to everybody, and when I'm reacting to this video, I'm trying to do it the most respectful way, and I really do have respect for everybody. I just can't come over those mass shootings, like they stand in a line and just, wow, they just die online, man. I'm just a little kid. Like, I couldn't kill a little kid in war, even if he had a machine gun. It would be hard for me. I don't know if he stood right in front of me with a machine gun and I stood at him in front with a weapon. I don't know. But I would never in my life shoot unarmed kids. Ever in my goddamn life. Ever. Because I work with kids. My education is about kids. And I would never do that. I would never in my life shoot or hit or, you know, mistreat a little kid because, you know, they don't deserve it. But this is hard to say. But anyway, let's just get out of this. It's an amazing video. And yeah, first thing I want to say is just thank you to this guy right here. Thank you so much for requesting this video. You make me very sad. You make me depressed. But it's okay, brother. It's okay. I really do appreciate it. And sometimes I have to see these videos to realize there's a history. But I keep forgetting because I have to live my life. And I just treat people as good as I can. And that's my mission, you know? So yeah. But anyway, thank you so much to this guy, as I said. And please, 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 it would mean the world to me if you did subscribe to the channel, because I'm trying to hit 500 subscribers. And I really do appreciate you guys that already subscribed. And if you don't want to subscribe, that's totally okay. Just leave a like down in the video if you like this video and you like this reaction. And respect to Russia and respect to everybody that lost the war. Anyway, if you didn't like the video, bug off. I don't want to hear from you. I understand if you don't like the video, you can leave a dislike, whatever you want to do. I'm not stopping you. It's freedom of speech. It's freedom of, you know, interaction. So, yeah. But anyway, guys, I'm going to move on to the next request that we have. So, yeah. Anyway, I'm going to see you into the next video. Peace.